cancer fundraiser for people on low income. I think entrepreneurship is a way to following my passion.
This is the Bible Buzz, the founder and CEO of ICE, a social enterprise which makes and sells healthcare products for women and girls. She's 39 and is from Chennai in India, which is part of the The Bible Buzz has had her work recognized by the UN. She's been named a young global leader by the World Economic Forum. She's given a popular TED Talk, which has had over 38,000 views. On the next 6 minutes, if you will listen to me, the world will have lost 3 mothers by delivering their babies. She told me about ICE's first product. Now, the product basically is a kit that has 6 surgical supplies that are essential for infection reduction during childbirth. And these supplies basically are what are recommended by the World Health Organization for infection prevention. The product contains about a 7 sheet for the woman to be delivering the baby on, a surgical scalpel to cut down the open parts, a pair of gloves, a bar of soap, and a first cloth to wipe the baby clean. All this comes in a beautiful pink purse, and this is sold as a product for $3. And we've sold this in about 13 countries, and we are at about 500,000 products in the market. The World Health Organization estimates that infection leads to over a third of neonatal deaths. Zubaida told me about 50% of the company that took low-cost, profile proven technologies to market, which had impact on women. I met with a midwife who I struck a conversation with, and she basically explained to me how she used an agricultural tool to conduct childbirth in the house. And that basically sparked the aha moment when I wanted to figure out what was wrong, because I personally had an infection during childbirth, and that was because my gynecologist forgot to put me on antibiotics. And so I could relate to the pain of infection that a woman would go through, and I think I spent about 2 years researching into this subject area and talking to various experts, and I also did a fellowship in women's health through Ashoka and the Gates Foundation. So I developed the product and then launched the product commercially in 2012. We were using razor blades that men would use for shaving. There was absolutely no gloves being used.